Good morning, and welcome to Ephesians of Richmond's Sunday morning virtual worship service. We invite you to experience the worship, experience the glory, and experience the praise with us as we lift up the name of Jesus today.
We pray peace.
Oh,
in this time of fighting.
In this time of fighting.
We pray love.
Love.
In this time of hating.
In this time of hating.
We pray safety.
We pray safety.
In this time
in this time of killing,
the joy of the Lord,
send your joy, God.
In this time of stressing,
in this time of stressing,
we pray Goshen,
Goshen,
Goshen.
It's God's protection.
Almighty.
Oh,
God's protection.
Let's say it again, y'all. Come on.
We pray peace.
We pray peace.
In this time of fighting,
in this time of fighting,
we pray love.
Love.
In this time.
In this time of hating,
we pray safety.
We pray safety.
In this time of killing,
for you and your family.
The joy of the Lord.
The joy of the Lord.
In this time of stressing.
In this time of stressing.
We pray Goshen.
When we pray Goshen,
Goshen.
We're praying protection.
Almighty.
Oh. Good afternoon, and welcome to the services at the Ephesians Church of God in Christ, located in the city of Richmond, California, where our pastor is Superintendent Louis B. Spicer, Jr. On this afternoon, one of the Mother's Board members will be delivering to you the word of the Lord, namely Missionary Eleanor Thompson. On this afternoon, she will be speaking to you regarding who needs a miracle. Would you be one of those who is in need of a miracle on today? I know I am. So think about it prayerfully and persistently if you need a miracle in your life. If you do, Jesus Christ is the one who will be the miracle worker. So once again, we ask that you sit prayerfully and persistently as you listen to the word of the Lord. Missionary Eleanor Thompson has been a lifetime member here at the Ephesians Church of God in Christ. She is also an alternate Sunday school teacher. So once again, we ask that you sit prayerfully, persistently, but very patiently, and listen to the profound word of the Lord. God bless you on this afternoon, and we trust that you will be blessed and encouraged by this profound word of God. Now let's go into the service of the Lord. God bless you on today, and may you be encouraged as you hear the word of God.
Oh, praise you, Jesus. Come on and help me worship him. Help me praise the name of Jesus and lift him up right now. We glorify your name, oh God. Oh, you are highly exalted in this place on tonight. We thank you, God. We praise you, Jesus, wonderful Savior. You are the Prince of Peace and the Lord of Lords. You are the King of Kings. We honor you. We glorify you. Oh, bless your name, Jesus. Hallelujah. We give you the highest praise today. We give you the highest praise, oh God. Bless you. Oh, with the waving of our hands, we give you a wave offering on today. We praise you, oh God. You're wonderful. You're glorious. You are magnificent, God. Oh, hallelujah. We just come to your throne. Your throne of grace right now in the mighty name of Jesus. And we are offering prayer up for the names that will be called out today. Sister Irmin Hollenquist, Valencia Fleming, Mabel Anderson, Alexander family at the loss of Mrs. Vernell Alexander. Oh, we praise you, Jesus. For Mother Ruby Lee Timmons, Mother Emma Hollenquist, Elder Henry Kimball, Artist Hollenquist, Mother Verna Robinson, Francis Matthews, Bishop Curtis Timmons, Benny Buford, Bonita Alexander, Edna Preston, Mother Bertie Stafford, Robert Alexander, Felicia Anderson, Pam Granger, Jasmine Miller, Anthony Terry, Jack Spicer II, Jack Spicer III, Pastor Kellis Love, Kamisha, Aretha Cook, Pastor Hernell Clayton, Doris Jeffries, Marion Cross, Denise Brown, Elaine Frank, Jessica Rucker, James Tidwell, Troy Hudson Sr., Jory Hudson, Don Flemings, Valerie Flemings, Gwendolyn Nett Hudson, Kenneth Brown Jr., Jamie Preston, and prayers for the Verna Robinson family, the Holiday, Baker and Brown families during their time of bereavement, Brantley Kimmons, Tamonte Cook, Lathan Thompson, Reggie Caldwell Jr., Leon Ferguson, Sean Miller, and Nicholas Kimmons, the Hayes and Bostic family at the loss of Willie Hayes, and missionary Eleanor Thompson. Father God, the names have went up before you right now into your throne room. As we look towards heaven, oh God, we just ask that you just touch right now. You know every situation. Hallelujah, you are the problem solver. We thank you, oh God, for every situation right now. You touch, oh God. Let your presence be made known in their homes right now, on their jobs, wherever they may be at right now, oh God. You go in, you touch right now. You minister to them, God. You encourage their hearts. We praise you, Jesus. We thank you, Lord. Oh, we praise you right now for what you're going to do and what you're doing right now as your virtue leave your body. Hallelujah. As it leave right now and touch each individual right now, that they may raise up and give a testimony of your power, of your mighty acts, and what you're doing and what you've done for them right now. Even as they raise up off their sick beds, their beds of affliction, oh God, and talk about the miracle that you have put in their bodies. Creative miracles, creative parts that are needed right now. In the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you, oh God. We praise you for signs and wonders being known and manifested in their homes right now. We thank you, oh God, because you are Jehovah Rapha, the God that healeth thee. Hallelujah. We thank you right now that their faith is strong right now. Hallelujah. Bless your name, Jesus. We praise you, oh God. We thank you for what you're doing, Father. Hallelujah. Bless your holy name. We love you tonight, and we glorify your name forever and evermore. And we praise you, oh God, and thank you for what you're doing right now. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen, amen, and amen.
We rejoice in the goodness of our God. And we celebrate his faithfulness today. Come on, somebody ought to worship with us. Hallelujah. Bless you, Lord. Bless you, Lord. Bless you, Lord. Here we go. Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the praises of our King rise among us. Let it rise. Oh my. Let the glory of the Lord rise among us, say, let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the praises of our King rise among us. Let it rise. Let it rise. Come on, everybody sing. Let the glory of the Lord.
The glory of the Lord rise among
let
us.
Let the glory.
The glory of the Lord.
Let it rise.
Rise among us. The praises of our King. Rise among us. Let it rise.
Let the glory of the Lord.
Among us, let the glory of the Lord rise.
Let the praises
of our King,
wherever you are, come on, let it rise.
Let it rise.
Sing it, oh. Come on, harmony, let the glory.
Glory of the Lord rise above.
Everybody sing.
Glory of the Lord rise.
Let the praises of our the praises of our King rise among us. Let it rise. I'll say it again. Hey, let the song of the Lord, let it rise among us. Let the song of the Lord rise among us. Let the praises of our King, let it rise among us. Let it rise. Come on, all the worshipers say, let the song,
song of the Lord rise among us. Let the song of the Lord,
you say,
rise among us.
Let the praises of our King,
the praises of our King, rise among us. Let it rise.
Come on, join in, everybody. Let the song of the Lord,
song of the Lord,
let it
Hallelujah.
Lord, I thank you for allowing me to be here again, God, in your presence. Lord, I ask that you bless each and every one that's here on today, God. I ask that you stretch out your hand all over Richmond, all over the world, God. Bless and heal. Lord, bless and heal. The young man that was in the hospital on Facebook, God, he asked the saints to pray for him. God, we're praying that you'll heal his body, God, and send him home. Only you can do it, God, and we're waiting for you to heal. We know you can do it. We know you will do it. Hallelujah. All we have to do is believe. Hallelujah. Just trust in you, and you will heal not only him, God, but you will heal all over the world. Heal each and everyone who have the virus, God. Heal them right now. Touch their body, God. And send those who are in the hospital, God. Send them home, God, because we know that you are a powerful God. And we know that you can do it. In the name of Jesus. Lord, bless this word on today. In Jesus' name, amen. Lord, I want to thank you right now for being here. And I hope I do Mother Anderson's topic justice. And her topic for today is, who wants a miracle? Anybody wants a miracle? We all want miracles. And the scripture today is talking about the woman with the issue of blood. She needed to be healed. And she knew that the only way she could be healed was that she touched the hem of Jesus' garment. She didn't say he had to come and pray for her. She didn't say he had to put his hands on her. She said, if I could just touch the hem of his garment, I know I'll be made whole. Hallelujah. And our scripture is coming from Luke 8:43, and I'm going to read Luke 8:43 through 48. Says, in a woman having an issue of blood 12 years, which has spent all her living upon physicians, neither could be healed of any. So neither of them could heal her, no matter how much money she spent. So it don't matter how much money we have. It cannot heal our body when we get sick. Only God can do that. And it says, came behind him and touched the border of his garment. And immediately her issue of blood stanched. And Jesus said, who touched me? When all denied, Peter and they that were with him said, Master, the multitude thronged thee and pressed thee and says, thou, who touched me? And Jesus said, somebody hath touched me. See, Jesus knew the difference. For I perceive that virtue is gone out of me. And when the woman saw that she was not hid, she came trembling and falling down before him. She declared unto him before all the people for what cause she had touched him and how she was healed immediately. So it don't take no long time for God to do a healing. He can heal immediately. Matter of fact, he don't even have to be there to heal. He can heal just speaking a word. So we don't have to worry. All we have to do is ask him to do it, and he'll do it. 48. And he said unto her, daughter, be of good comfort. Thy faith hath made thee whole. Go in peace. So her faith, it's about our faith that help us to be healed when we pray to God. A lot of time we can speak about things and speak a lot of negativity into our lives, and that keeps us being miserable. But he says, speak positivity into your life. And if you do that, I'll heal you. If you do that, I'll bless you. If you do that, just ask me for whatever you want, and I'll do it. And so when we're talking about miracles, somebody else needed a miracle. And that was Jonah. God told Jonah to go over to Nineveh to preach to the people. But he didn't go. Instead, what he did, he tried to run away from God. Do you know we can't run away from God? You know that saying that says you can run, but you can't hide. So no matter where we go, God sees us, and he knows everything we do. So when he did not go to Nineveh to preach the word like God told him to, instead he ran away and got on a ship. So Jonah 1, 16 and 17, and then verse chapter 2, 1 through 10. Okay, 16 and 17 says, then the men feared the Lord exceedingly and offered a sacrifice unto the Lord and made vows. So these people didn't know what was going on. All they knew that there was a storm raging, and they couldn't find out why. They want to know, why are we having a storm out here on the sea? So went on to 17, it says, now the Lord had prepared a great fish to swallow up Jonah, and Jonah was in the belly of the fish 3 days and three nights. Okay, he was in the belly of the fish for 3 days and three nights. He needed a miracle. Did he need a miracle? And guess what? The only way he got a miracle is that he found out who God was. We already knew who he was, but then he started to pray because he needed God. When Jonah prayed unto the Lord, his God out of the prayed unto the Lord, his God out of the fish's belly, and said, I cried by reason of my affliction unto the Lord, and he heard me. Out of the belly of hell cried I. So God can hear you wherever you are. And thou hearest my voice, for thou hadst cast me into the deep, in the midst of the seas, and the floods compassed me about. All thou billows and thou waves passed over me. Then I said, I am cast out of thy sight, yet I will look again toward thy holy temple. The waters compassed me about, even to the sole of the depths closed me round about. The weeds were wrapped about my head. So can you imagine how fearful that must be? I'm at the bottom of the sea and I'm in the belly of a fish. Hallelujah. Ha, ha, ha. Are we thinking about how I'm going to get out of here? What I'm going to do? But then you think about God has all the power. Says he has all the power. Says I went down to the bottom of the mountains. The earth with her bars was about me forever. Yet hast thou brought up my life from corruption, O Lord, my God. When my soul fainted within me, I remembered the Lord. Hey, he remembered God. So do we get in situations sometimes and we have forgotten about God, but do we remember who he is? Do we remember how much power he has? Says he remembered God. And my prayer came in unto thee, into thine holy temple. They that observe lying vanities forsake their own mercy. But I will sacrifice unto thee with the voice of thanksgiving. I will pay that I have vowed salvation is of the Lord. And the Lord spake unto the fish, and it vomited out Jonah upon the dry land. So God spoke. He spoke to the fish and said this, and said it vomited Jonah up on dry land. So it vomited him out of his stomach on dry land. So when I was reading this, and then I thought about, a lot of time we do things and we make mistakes. Jonah made a mistake. The mistake he made was he didn't do what God asked him to do. So then he decided he was going to go get on a ship and hide from God. But we can't hide from God. Didn't we say God can see everywhere and God can see everything? So he called himself hide from God, and he was down in the ship sleeping. But when the storm came, the people got scared, and they went down in the ship and asked him, who is your God? And so when Jonah got to telling them about his God and that he was the cause of this storm, they threw him overboard. Said when they threw him overboard, the storm ceased. So once he was off the ship, it was all on him. He was in the belly of the fish. And that was because he made a mistake. We make mistakes, but you know what? God don't forget about us. Because we make a mistake, God don't leave us. Ha, no, 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 ha. Your brothers, your sister, your family, they might leave you. But when you make a mistake, God don't leave you. He said, I'll stick by you through thick and thin. But you get it right. Hallelujah. I'll be there if you need me. I'll be there when you need me the most. Hallelujah. And Jonah needed him right then. Jonah needed him because he was in the belly of the fish. And he didn't know how he was going to get out. But he decided he needed to pray to God because he knew God knew just what he needed. Hallelujah. Hey, thank you, Jesus. Lord, I thank you right now. Hallelujah. Sometimes we can get off course. We get off course because we might want to follow our friends. We might want to do what we want to do, and it's not of God. But then God say, I didn't forget about you. You're yet my child. But I might say, uh-uh. You should have did it right the first time. But God don't do that. He don't hold nothing against you. And you know what? It's because of his mercy and his grace. Hallelujah. He said, I'll give you new mercy every day. All you have to do is trust me. Do what I ask you to do. Hallelujah. If you do what I ask you to do, you won't go wrong. So we have to live like God wants us to live. Don't live like friends want us, because friends will get us in a lot of trouble. Sometimes they'll get us in trouble and we can't get out. Hallelujah. They can get us off path and get us off course. But we want to stay and walk the straight and narrow way. Hallelujah. We want to be like the woman with the issue of blood. She trusted God so much. Ha, ha, ha. She said, if I could just touch the hem of his garment, if I could just touch it, I don't need him to lay no hands on me. I don't need him to come to my house and pray for me. Hallelujah. But if I could just touch the hem of his garment, I know I'll be made whole. Hallelujah. And when we think about a miracle, and Daniel in the lion's den, he didn't have to worry because he knew God was on his side. And if God is on our side, then it says he's more than the world against us. He is more than the world against us. The world can be against us, but if Jesus is for us, ha, na, 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 ha, that's all we need. We don't need no friends. We don't need no money, because money can't buy salvation. We don't need no money, because money can't buy life. Hallelujah. When you're in your sick bed, money can't bring you out. But God said, ha, na, 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 ha, if you trust in me, I will raise you up. Because when Lazarus died, they thought that he was dead, you know, and wouldn't come back. But God, Jesus said, just because I wasn't there, that don't mean that I can't bring him back. He said, I can work miracles. I can do miracles. Can we do a miracle right now? If we have the faith. Because that's what it talked about. It talked about how much faith do you have. Lazarus was dead. But Jesus said, I'm not too late. Who was that? Mary and Martha? They said, you're late. You didn't come on time. He said, I'm not too late. Hallelujah. because I can raise the dead. Hallelujah. I can heal the sick. Hallelujah. I can deliver. I can solve problems that we can't solve. So let's just say that God is where we should put our trust. We should trust in him no matter what. Sometimes it don't look good, but yet we should trust in him. Sometimes we can block our blessings because we don't trust him. We can block the blessing that he promised us, the blessing that he want to give to us because of our actions. We can block our blessing. So we just have to believe in God. We have to trust in God. We have to believe that God can do anything, that God can do everything. Lord, we thank you right now, God. Lord, we ask that you heal, Lord. Lord, go into the hospital, God. Lord, touch the young man that was on Facebook, God. He said, please pray for me. Lord, we want to pray right now, God. We ask that you touch him right now, God. Deliver him, Lord. Lord, bring him out the hospital all right, because we know that you can do it. Lord, we ask that you stretch your hand out all over Richmond, God, all over the world, God. Lord, we ask that you heal right now, that you heal our land, Lord. Hallelujah. Lord, we ask that you do it right now, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, amen.
Come on, tell him you love him. There's nobody like
him. Praise him.
Hallelujah.
Praise him.
His name is Jesus.
Jesus. Blessed Savior.
He's worthy to be praised. From the rising. From the rising of the sun.
Going down
to
the going down.
on, stay right here. Jesus, call his name, Jesus. There's no other name like him.
Jesus.
Oh.
Development Center, in partnership with the State of California Department of Education, is distributing fresh fruits and vegetables every Tuesday afternoon from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. For your convenience, we have two sites to serve you. Site number one is right here at Ephesians Church of God in Christ, located in the Richmond Village at 2887 Foothill Avenue, Richmond, California. Site number two is our mobile site where you can drive up and receive contactless service while you have the produce loaded right into your vehicle. We're located on the corner of Cutting and 26, right here in Richmond. Again, those hours are 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. every Tuesday. You can join in on our virtual worship experiences via our website, which is www.ecogicrca.org. Or you can join us on Facebook Live, YouTube, or Zoom. We invite you to walk through the Bible with us as we present inspiring lessons filled with practical advice for everyday living during our Sunday school. Sunday school takes place at 10 a.m. on Sunday mornings via Zoom. Immediately following Sunday school at 11:30 a.m., we invite you to experience the glory, experience the worship, and experience the praise with us during our virtual morning worship service. The Bible says men ought to always pray, and here at Ephesians, we believe in the power of prayer. Meet us for prayer Monday, Wednesday, and Friday mornings at 7 a.m. on our prayer call. If evenings work better for you, you can join us on Tuesday and Thursday evenings at 6:30 p.m. The number to call in is 669-900-9128. meeting ID is 723-669-3539. Can't make it to the prayer call but have a prayer request? You may email us your prayer request at ecogicrca@gmail.com. Again, that's ecogicrca@gmail.com, and we will add your prayer to the list. Join us on Tuesday evenings for Bible study. Whether you're a seasoned Bible scholar or a recent convert to Christ, we invite you to expand your knowledge, feed your faith, and become empowered with sound Bible teachings and the Word of God. Coming soon, join us as we launch the ECDC Technology Center. This will serve as a no-fee computer technology and training center. Grand opening and ribbon cutting information to follow. If you would like to partner with us here at Ephesians of Richmond and sow a tax-deductible seed into this ministry, we have multiple giving platforms to help you do so. Our Cash App ID is $ECOGICRCA. If you would like to give via PayPal, you can use our email address, which is ECOGICRCA@gmail.com. You can also give through our website, which is www.ecogicrca.org, and follow the prompts for giving. If you would like to give via the pray.com platform, you can search our name, which is Ephesians of Richmond. Lastly, you can give by mail at P.O. Box 2950, Richmond, California, 94802. We thank you in advance for your support, and may God bless you. If you prayed the prayer of salvation today and made Jesus the Lord and Savior of your life, we welcome you to the body of Christ. We have a salvation package that we'd like to send to you regarding a change in living and a new walk in the Lord. You may write to us at P.O. Box 2950, Richmond, California, 94802. You may email us at ecogicrca@gmail.com, or you may call us at 510-234-5049. We're looking forward to growing stronger together in the Lord with you.